Call the Reading Writing Hotline 06. 1300 655.
It's the ad earworm that could haunt you if NAPLAN results continue to be this spooky.
1300 655 06. This report today shows that for young people, particularly in high school, that writing skills are going in the wrong direction.
Up to 6 years in the wrong direction, as new research reveals Aussie students have fallen far behind in their persuasive writing skills. The study of more than 10 million NAPLAN results from 2011 to 2021 found most Year 9 students use Grade 3 level punctuation, while less than half are capable of constructing sentences.
As they move off into life, they need to be able to write persuasively as well. Life after school isn't just text messages.
With almost half of New South Wales teachers saying they weren't confident to teach structure, grammar and punctuation, the writing's on the wall.
They don't feel they've been well trained to teach writing and they would like some help.
A decade ago, a fifth of students achieved NAPLAN's highest writing scores. That number has more than halved. The study also finding a focus on reading skills may have written off writing.
Over the last 10 years, we've seen a real focus from government on the teaching of reading. We need a similar kind of approach now to writing, because learning writing doesn't come naturally. It needs to be taught.
But everyone agrees the biggest barrier is time, even though that's maths.
The typical teacher is spending 6 hours a week developing their own lesson plans. Some teachers a lot more than that.
We need to allow our teachers to prioritise the precious resource of time in their classrooms for young people to be able to practice the art of writing.
It's not too late to turn this around. We can fix the problem even for students who are in Year 9 right now. There is an answer.
I just wonder whether the truth is language and communication evolves all the time. It has forever. It will continue to. It's not like young people are not communicating. Someone in Year 9 is still communicating with their parents, their friends, their teachers, just doing it differently.
When I get a text that says G to G, which means got to go from my son,
yes,
that's not communicate. That's not developing critical thinking.
I don't know if it's evolving or devolving, to be honest.
But don't you think in 100 years, 200 years' time, if the planet is still here, we may look back at this sort of quaint period of time where we used to handwrite things and use a semicolon and get people in trouble for putting the apostrophe in the wrong spot.
I think so, but I think it also underestimates the value that reading and confidence and comprehension and confidence and the connection between thought and a pen. It's sort of like the way we all just wear tracksuit pants now. Are we better for it?
We can still do that, can't we?
No, I know, but it's like it kind of sums up that we've just taken this, pot-bellied view to everything.
But I mean, even look at my son Ollie, right? So before he could write essays and, you know, he saw the world in a much simpler way, once he developed that skill, and he had to be taught, we spent hours with him teaching him how to form essays, structure and all of that. But even the way he thinks about the world and watches TV and watches films and stuff, he comes at it from a different
yes.
way because he's learnt some of those
analytical
skills.
Or
do you know what I mean?
And you think it's because of his use of grammar that he understands the world in that way?
But I think the grammar,
is a
can
tool
order
to
grammar
there.
Is all part of it.
Grammar's
it's not the
just
only
so
thing
you can
need.
Order thoughts. Grammar's not a bunch of rules for no reason.
But you're talking about this, you know, through the art of using a pen. When was the last time you wrote something with a pen?
You wrote a lot of your book with a pen, didn't you?
I mean, you've got doodles all over that page.
Yeah. I wrote messages too.
Maybe.
Yeah, that's right. I didn't want to say what I just wrote to you before.
I do write like with pens, though. Like, absolutely. Yeah. And if I'm developing, say, an hour of comedy, I will usually write more of it with my hand, and then I'll eventually go and start working on a computer to see. And it's two different experiences.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I think
Absolutely.
The negating of that, and also teachers don't have time, because every time something comes up, people are like, we need to teach them that at school. They need to how to balance their bank account at school.
It's such a good impression. It really
but
is.
Teachers get asked to teach everything and do all the admin. There's not time.